Hello, this is Spartan Commander, and this is the 629th Rome Total War Brotherhood game that I've put onto YouTube. Straight away, you'll see this is fought on one of my favourite maps, the Germanic Forest map, with the big open plains where you can fight out in the open if you want. Nice flat open plains there. Or if you want to hide your troops in the woods and spring those nasty ambushes out on the enemy troops, you can do that too on this map. So I think you've got most of what you want in a map. On this map. Okay, our first teammate is Brotherhood member Firstprime. Now Firstprime's got the bog standard 31k Roman army of 14 infantry and 6 cavalry, and the reason that's the bog standard 31k Roman army is because it's so effective and so efficient. That's why so many people bring this type of 31k army, and that's why it's the bog standard Roman 31k army. Okay, our next teammate is Brotherhood member Aurelius. Aurelius has got 11 Spartans, 2 armored hoplites, 4 archers and an armored cavalry general. And you'll just show you the difference there between the armored hoplites there and the Spartans, maybe for newer players to Rome Total War. Don't forget those Spartans got 2 hit points, excellent specifications, excellent morale, so are excellent infantry all round. And there's the armored cavalry general. You don't see that very often. Usually they bring most people bring an infantry general, so unusual to see that. And as I say, this is Aurelius's faction of choice now, I think. And of course, as I say, I think he's one of the best players at using a peasant unit in the game. He uses this unit to attract expensive enemy arrows and expensive enemy pilers to shoot at this cheap unit. And he's very good with that particular unit. Okay, our next teammate is Brotherhood member Earth. Now, Earth has got 8 infantry, 6 archers, and 6 cavalry. Now, 8 infantry, is that enough for the modern day battlefield? And they've only got gold shield, gold attack on. So what do you guys think? Do you think 8 infantry with just gold shield, gold attack on is good enough on a modern day battlefield? Now his cavalry, there you are, you can see he's got fully upgraded Praetorian cavalry, 3 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack. Okay, so will that maximum upgraded cavalry and those 6 archers make up for just 8 infantry? I guess we'll just have to see as the battle unfolds, but this seems to be Earth's standard Roman army that he brings to most battles now, so we'll know that he'll be very, very comfortable with that particular army. Our last teammate is myself, Spartan Commander, who's got his very old Roman army of 12 infantry and 6 cavalry. Okay, so there's our team. It's got the potential to be a cracking battle. And here is the other team. We have Hoss member Luke here. Now Luke has got 10 infantry, 4 archers and 6 cavalry. Okay, quick look at the upgrades on his cavalry. Usually brings serious cavalry, and there you are, he's got 8 upgrades, 2 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack. But is 10 infantry enough infantry for the modern day battlefield? I guess we'll just have to see as the battle unfolds, but this seems to be the standard Roman army that Luke brings, so he must be quite comfortable with that. Okay, their next teammate is Brotherhood member Mantu, who has unusually bought the Dacia faction. How often do we see Dacia on the 31k battlefield? Very rare. He's got 5 archers, 9 infantry and 6 cavalry. Now I'd like to draw your attention to, though, he has just gone for the archer warband here rather than chosen archers. Okay, so he's gone for like kind of the secondary archers here. So I'm guessing that he's done that to save himself a bit of money. Maybe he can put more money on his infantry, possibly. Let's have a look at the upgrades on his infantry there. And I think he's got 8 upgrades. 2 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack on his infantry. Chosen swordsman there. So I'm thinking that he's probably spent most of his money on his cavalry there, if he's only got 8 upgrades on his chosen swordsman. Let's have a look now. And so that 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, fully upgraded barbarian noble cavalry there. Okay, 3 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack there on that barbarian noble cavalry. So that's an interesting Dacia army build there. And as I say, very rare to see it on a 31k battlefield. Be interested to see how well it does. Okay, their next teammate is Brotherhood member LacJac. Now LacJac has got 11 infantry, 3 archers, and 6 cavalry. Okay. And if you look at the upgrades on his infantry, you'll see he's got 7 upgrades, an experience stripe, gold shield, gold attack on some of his infantry units. On other infantry units, he's just got gold shield, gold attack. So he's certainly got mixed upgrades on his infantry. And his cavalry have got 7 upgrades and experience, stripe, gold shield, gold attack on his cavalry there. So I think that's quite a balanced Roman army there. It'll be interesting to see how well that does during the course of the battle. And their last teammate, who's somewhere here in the woods, so I'm pretty sure we'll find them. There they go. And their last teammate is RTW player Surena. Now, Surena has got 11 infantry, 3 archers, and 6 cavalry. Okay, 11 infantry, 3 archers, and 6 cavalry. So there's the enemy team. I say it's got the potential to be a really good battle, and a very close battle, but I wonder which way it's going to go. Should be a good one to see. Okay, at this stage of the battle, I remember Earth said to me, did I want to swap with him? And he wanted to come on to the left flank, and I took his position in the left centre there. Okay, so you'll notice there, I'm going to take the left centre there. Let's just say Earth is going to go round on the left flank there with his infantry, archers and cavalry. Okay. And over here on our right flank, you'll see that Luke is like doing a flanking action there on his own, taking his cavalry and infantry around our flank there. So it wouldn't surprise me if he took his cavalry up behind us here. That's a tactic that I see he uses quite a lot, getting his cavalry in behind enemy troops. But he must be aware that he mustn't get isolated over on that flank. Sometimes I think, as I say in other battle videos that we've seen, if you get too aggressive, you can become isolated. And then, of course, you're ripe to be hit from the enemy team there. As I say, you can see here, Earth being his usual aggressive attacking self there, taking his archers over to that left flank, backed up by his infantry and cavalry. As I say, you can see clearly there what he's going to do there on the left flank in action against the enemy troops there. Okay, at this stage of the battle, I'd just like to talk about an RTW player who's called Surena. Now, some RTW players may well think that Surena is a female name, but it actually isn't. Surena was the general in charge of the Parthian army at the Battle of Carhi. This is where 9,000 horse archers and 1,000 heavily armoured cataphracts defeated a Roman army of maybe 35,000. Okay, and Surena was a really good general because Surena kept arrows supplied to those 9,000 horse archers all the way through the day. So you imagine the volume of arrows hitting those Roman legionnaires. Even though those Roman legionnaires were in testudo, the volume of arrows coming in at them all day was hitting their legs, ankles, feet, causing casualties. And Surena was a really good general, and the tactics that Surena used at the Battle of Carhi are really, really interesting. If you haven't read about the battle, you might find that quite interesting. But as I say, I think several RTW players may well think that Surena sounds a female name, but is in fact a male general. Have you ever heard of a thing called the Parthian shot? And that is where Parthian archers could turn their bodies 180 degrees in the saddle as they're riding away from chasing enemies and still shoot accurate arrows into those chasing troops and shoot them out the saddle. So I just thought I'd like to explain that to you. Okay, at this stage of the battle, we've entered a little bit of an archer war here. As you can see, some of our allies, Cretan archers there, shooting into those Dacian archer warband there. If you notice here, once again, you can see Aurelius taking that peasant unit forward there. As I say, hoping to soak up a lot of expensive enemy arrows or pilas, preferably, there into the cheapest unit in the game. As I say there, you can see he is being shot at there. You can see archer fire going into him. So once again, that tactic of using the cheapest unit in the game to soak up other enemy troops' missiles is working again for him. As I say, I think Aurelius is probably the best user of a peasant unit in the whole game. And here you can see, as I say, Earth here doing a left flanking action here. Probably going to border into the woods a little bit there by the looks of it. And may well turn the flank here. Surena may well either move over or turn to face a threat there. You can see Surena seems to have some units into testudo and then decided not to go into testudo. Usually, as I say, when you go into testudo, you're going into a defensive formation there. So I decided to come out of there. Okay, so over on our right flank here, you can see... right, let's just pause the game for a second here. Okay, so you can see, as I say, Hoss Luke there over on our right flank. He's got his cavalry gradually getting in behind us there. Okay, but he is quite isolated from his teammates, isn't he? Can you see he's quite a long way from his teammates? Now, what if First Prime and myself, with our cavalry and infantry there, smash in to, say, LacJac's Julio infantry while Luke is away from his teammates? That may be something we may well be thinking of there. I think First Prime was thinking that, the way he's moving his infantry over there, and leave Aurelius there to engage Hoss Luke's infantry. Okay, so just say Luke a long way from his allies there, and if we're fast here, quick, we may well be able to possibly do a double team on LacJac there. It's something that I think First Prime was thinking about there, as we both charge in there. Let's say Earth doing a really good job there on that left flank. Remember, Earth's only got 8 infantry. So I think that the way that he moves that infantry around the battlefield is going to have to be extremely tactical to kind of make up for just 8 infantry. And he usually uses this army extremely well. As I say, this is his standard Roman army, so he's comfortable with it. As I say, to a lot of players, 8 infantry wouldn't be enough. But as I say, he's comfortable and used to that number now. So here you can see Aurelius has been a nuisance with his fast-moving armoured cavalry general. I think he'd weakened or taken out some of the enemy archers there, but unfortunately just stayed in the fray a little bit longer than what he probably wanted to there, and that unit's been routed, but I think his general's still alive. Okay, so as I say, I think First Prime's plan here was to leave Aurelius here to counter Luke, where First Prime and myself go for LacJac. I think that was the plan in this particular game. And you can see now Hoss Luke just seeing what we're going to do and now decided to move over maybe towards his allies. But as I say, First Prime, we know First Prime's always been an aggressive attacking player since he formed the Core Clan right back in the early days of Rome Total War. He was the leader of the Core Clan and was always an aggressive attacking player. The battles that we used to fight back in the early days against the other enemy armies was actually fantastic games in those days. As I say here, you can see Earth getting around the flank of Surena's Scipii infantry here. Okay, so that's Aurelius. His general's just been taken out. And you can see Aurelius now is bringing his Spartan army, his Greek city's army, over towards Luke's Brutio army, which has now decided to come back towards his allies. There's been a bit of pilot exchanging going on here. Anybody notice anything unusual about First Prime and LacJac's battle formation? Anybody notice anything here in a Roman battle formation? One thing that sticks out a mile to me here. Can anybody else see anything here? Okay, very unusual. Neither army has got a pilot shield unit in front of it. Can you see? Neither, not First Prime or LacJac. Can you see? Pilot shield units in open order suffer a heck of a lot less damage from enemy pilots than units in close tight formation, and neither First Prime or LacJac has got pilot shield units in front of their main battle formation. Very unusual there. So they're going to suffer a lot of casualties, and here you can see one of my pilot shield units in open order will be inflicting a heck of a lot of damage on this close tight for unit formation here. See? That's what I mean. Units in this close tight formation suffer a heck of a lot more casualties than units in open order. Okay, so you can see First Prime's going in now. Wouldn't surprise me if LacJac backed off. There you go. You can see LacJac's backing his Julia army off there as First Prime moved forward. As I say, Aurelius is going to counter Luke there on the right flank. And as usual there, you'll see Earth being very aggressive on the other flank there, getting round the enemy Scipii army there. So there's a general overview of the battle as it stands at the moment. But as I say, First Prime, as we know, very aggressive, very attacking. I think he's just going to keep going for LacJac. And there you are, you can see he's going to go for LacJac there. Look at him. Bang! As his forward units crash in to LacJac's forward units there. So as you can see there, First Prime being very, very aggressive there as he charges into LacJac's infantry. Now remember, LacJac's infantry have got an experienced stripe, gold shield, gold attack. Let's say a lot of pilot exchanging going on here now between the two armies. Let's say you can see Aurelius there turning it the flank, if you like, there to face Hoss Luke's Brutii infantry. Okay, here, so as I say, you can see Aurelius facing the threat, but you can see LacJac's Julii cavalry there, which I'm thinking he's going to take in behind us and maybe possibly link up with Luke's Brutii cavalry that's in behind us as well. Okay, so there could be a cavalry threat here on our flank, or even to get in behind us here. As I say, Hoss Luke there has got in behind us, look, with his cavalry looking to charge into the rear of our engaged units if he gets the chance. Okay, but both First Prime and my cavalry there is waiting to engage the enemy there. And as I say, here you can see First Prime being very aggressive here. And I say, a nice bit of support there by Aurelius Lux, throwing a few of his Spartan units in to hit LacJac's Julii infantry in the flank there. Nice support there by Aurelius. And as I say, over on the left flank here, you can see that Earth there being very aggressive, trying to get round the flank there, trying to turn the enemy flank there. Some pilot exchanging going on there, but remember that Earth's only got 8 infantry. So he's going to, as I say, be very tactical, very strategic with the way he moves that infantry around the battlefield, but he is used to that small amount of infantry, as this is his Roman army of choice. Right here, you can see Aurelius now is charging into the flank of the enemy Julii troops there. You can see the enemy Brutii troops coming up towards him. Right, can you see that enemy Scipii cavalry going to smash into First Prime Centre? Get ready for this. Bang! As it smashes in there. Look at the impact and penetration of those Scipii cavalry. They smash through his battle line there. Look. Can you see how they smash through that? Oh my gosh, there is Dacian cavalry, fully upgraded cavalry there coming through as well. Right, LacJac's Julii cavalry is in behind. That's why First Prime didn't charge his cavalry in to try and help his infantry. Plus, you've got the Brutii cavalry in behind us as well. But as I say there, it looks like the enemy has smashed through the centre of First Prime's engaged infantry there. And if you notice there, it looks like First Prime's taking his infantry up towards the cavalry in behind us. As I say, you can see Aurelius here moving in towards the enemy Julii infantry. Plus, he's fighting Hoss Luke's Brutii infantry as well. Now, just like to show you a really great tactical move here by Earth. New players to Rome Total War. This is a great move, look. Go around the left flank, and he is now behind the enemy team. Okay, the only trouble is, if you get behind the enemy team, you have to be careful that you don't get isolated. Because if you get behind the enemy team, your allies can't get to you if, say, the enemy do a counterattack with lots of cavalry onto you. Okay, but meanwhile here, you can see that First Prime is moving some of his infantry units up here towards the enemy Julii cavalry, who are now charging into his cavalry. Get ready for this, and bang, as that Julii cavalry smashes in there. Oh my gosh, now you can see First Prime taking his infantry there as well into the fray. Okay, so let's just pause again for a second here. So you can see First Prime's infantry there and his cavalry fighting this Julii cavalry. You can see Hoss Luke's Brutii cavalry locked and loaded, and also you'll see that my SPQR cavalry is locked and loaded as well. So what I'm looking here is which one of us are going to smash into that fray first. If I smash in there, I'm hoping to be able to rout most of that Julii cavalry. That's what I'd like to do there. And don't forget, you've got First Prime's general there as well, giving morale bonus to my cavalry when I charge in there, and of course his own infantry. Here you can see Hoss Luke's Brutii infantry there, sending some of his units over to the fray at the rear, as well as fighting on the flank. But as I say, if you look here, can you see that First Prime's SPQR unit there has been routed? There's one SPQR unit of First Prime there and one over there, look, okay? But in between those two units is a big, massive hole in First Prime's battle line there that they could just charge through there. Remember that Dacian cavalry is fully upgraded. 9 upgrades, 3 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack, and could smash into the rear of First Prime's engaged infantry there, okay? So as I say, I've got my cavalry locked. I've decided to throw my cavalry in now. And you can see my cavalry coming in. You can see the enemy Brutii cavalry coming in as well. Get ready for this. And bang! Bang! And then the Brutii cavalry coming on this side. Bang! As they charge in there as well. And look at the impact there. We've routed most of that Julii cavalry there. Here comes that fully upgraded Dacian cavalry coming into the fray as well. And bang! As that barbarian noble cavalry smashes in there as well. Oh my gosh. Make no mistake, this could be the decisive pivotal part of the battle here. Let's say you can see enemy Brutii cavalry and infantry there. You can see that fully upgraded Dacian Barbarian Noble cavalry charging there as well. And First Prime and my cavalry and some of First Prime's infantry are involved there. But as I say, look, First Prime's battle line has been smashed and the enemy troops are pouring through there. Aurelius is doing a really good job on our right flank holding against LacJac's Julio troops and Luke's Brutio troops there. So well done to Aurelius on that right flank. And as I say, well done to Earth there getting in behind Serena's infantry there. But now Earth's going to face all of Serena's infantry and cavalry. And as I say, don't forget, Earth only had 8 infantry. And Surena, I think, had maybe 13 or 14 infantry units, so that's a massive difference there. And you can see several of Earth's units starting to rout now, which is bad news for us. Okay, but this battle at the back here of our battle line here, this could be, as I say, pivotal and decisive. You can see I'm running my infantry into the fray here as fast as I can to try and help out. My general's in there. You can see Hoss Luke is pulling some of his cavalry back, probably going to lock and load them to charge back in. Okay, let's just pause the game for a second here. Okay, so over here on our left flank, as I say, Earth did really well in getting in behind the enemy team, but he is now a little bit isolated. You can see a lot of his units have now been routed by Serena's Scipii cavalry and infantry. Remember, Serena had the numbers there. Okay, Serena had the numbers, and all Earth infantry was just gold shield, gold attack. Didn't even have any really good upgrades on, so you can see a lot of Earth's SBQR units are now routed. Let's say Aurelius has been doing an absolutely sterling job here on the right flank in facing both Julii infantry and enemy Brutii infantry there, so really well done to Aurelius there. Okay, but as I say, I'm charging my infantry over here into the rear here because I think, as I say, this could be the make or break of the battle here. You can see some Dacian Chosen Swordsmen coming over here. Remember, Chosen Swordsmen got excellent morale, and you'd be surprised on how good those Barbarian Chosen Swordsmen are, actually, if you look at their specifications. Here you can see Hoss's, Luke's cavalry charging there. Bang! Trying to take out First Prime's general. Nice tactical cavalry hit there. So I got my infantry involved here as well now, as my cavalry at the rear here against Dacian infantry and enemy Brutii infantry there as well. Oh my gosh, here comes Serena's Scipii cavalry and bang, it smashes in there. My cavalry has been very battle depleted. I got Brutii cavalry coming in behind me, and bang, as that smashes in there. I think that's basically all my cavalry has now been taken out. Let's just pause the game for a second here. So I've got my infantry there facing Brutii cavalry and infantry, and more of my infantry there facing Scipii and Brutii cavalry there as well, and Dacian infantry. So there's a heck of a lot going on at the back here. Unfortunately, it looks now that basically there's one, Earth's got one infantry unit left there being surrounded by Serena's Scipii troops. Now, when they take that unit out, and make no mistake, they will, all that Scipii infantry is then freed up, okay, to then come over into the fray and either attack the rear or flank of my engaged Roman troops there, or even go over and attack Aurelius's Greek cities there, okay? So all that infantry will be freed up once they take out that SBQR unit. Now Earth still got cavalry units there. He's still got one infantry unit left over there, but Earth's using his cavalry extremely well. Remember, his Praetorian cavalry is fully upgraded. 3 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack. Okay, but over here, I say I've got my infantry involved in the fighting here, trying to hold against Brutii and Dacian and Scipii cavalry as well here. Now remember, my infantry here, most of all the infantry that I've got left at this stage, I've got an experience stripe on. Now that could well prove pivotal, as we've talked about in other battle videos, especially towards the end of the battle there. Let's say I'm under a lot of pressure there from Brutii infantry. Now if you notice here, Luke's going to probably do a hammer and anvil attack. Here comes his cavalry, get ready for this, and bang, as he smashes in there. Now look at the penetration of that cavalry. Now I'm sure, and here comes some more Brutii cavalry, look at that, and bang, as he charges in there as well. Now I'm pretty sure that if my infantry was just gold shield, gold attack, that infantry of mine would have probably mass routed. But bearing in mind I got my general in there, and all the infantry I've got left have got an experience stripe on, that's why they held against that hammer and anvil attack. You saw the penetration of that cavalry, and yet my units didn't rout. That's what an experience stripe can do for your infantry, as I say, especially towards the end of the battle when you need that kind of extra resilience to keep fighting. Okay, so now I think that's the last of Earth's infantry units just been taken out, and so all these Scipioid cavalry and infantry are now freed up to come across to the battlefield to either attack our Greek city's ally or smash into the rear or flank of my engaged troops. Okay, so all these Scipioid infantry and cavalry now can come into the fray. As I say here, you can see that Luke's Brutii infantry and cavalry really trying to penetrate into my SBQR infantry, and yet my troops still hold. Okay, and here comes a great cavalry attack here by Earth. Get ready for this, and bang, as he smashed in there. Really great cavalry hit there. Here comes Surena's cavalry smashed into my infantry as well, and bang, as that smashes into my infantry. What an impact there. Look at the penetration of that cavalry there, smashing into my infantry. But once again, my infantry still holding there. That experience stripe, as I say, I know we bang on about this a bit, but that experience stripe can really make a difference, especially towards the end of the battle when your troops are tired and battle depleted. That experience stripe really keeps them going there. Oh my gosh, here comes all that Scipioid infantry into us as well here. But as I say, that was a nice cavalry charge there by Earth, straight into the rear of Hoss Luke's Brutii infantry there. Took out a lot of them hammer and anvil attack. My infantry being the anvil, his cavalry being the hammer there. Okay, so you can see I'm throwing my SBQR troops into this Scipioid infantry. Now here comes Luke's cavalry again, looking like he's going to smash into the rear of my engaged troops. Here it comes again, look, bang, as he smashes in there. Hoping to rout a lot of my units there. As you can see the penetration there, and now you can see Earth's cavalry charging in there. You can see Aurelius bringing his Spartans into the fray as well. Right, let's just pause the game for a second. Just wanted to show you something here. Can you see those two units of mine have routed? But look how many men are in them. One man in that unit, and one man in that unit. So those two units that fought down to one man in each unit before they routed. That's what an experience stripe can do for your infantry. As I say, over the years, I know we've banged on about experience stripes, but I'm just wanting to show you there how effective they can be. And there you can see Earth charging his fully upgraded cavalry in, plus Aurelius is charging his Spartans in as well there. So as I say, really good teamwork there as they charge in. I think Firstprime's rallied some of his infantry as well, and they're in there. The Surena's cavalry charging in there as well. Bang! That smashes in there, but between us we've managed to rout. I think Serena's infantry had been fighting a long time with Earth, so his infantry would have been battle depleted and tired there, and it looks like our team has managed to go on to win the battle there. Very grinding down battle at 13 men in one of my units there. Look, 20 men, that seems a lot now, doesn't it? 4 men left in that unit, 17 men in that unit, 15 men in that unit, what's that, 8 men and 11 men in that unit. So these are 82 man units, so you can see how much of a grinding down battle it was. Over here of course was where Surena fought Earth there, so you can see a lot of dead there, and I think there's a flying Roman soldier there. Oh yes, yeah, the battle's over now, so even when you land you're not gonna be able to help. So as we come over here, you can see a lot of dead Spartans. As I say, the Spartans' red cloaks always show up on the battlefield, don't they? You can always see where they've been fighting. And then over here, which is maybe the most intense part of the fighting here, if you just look at the massive piles of dead on top of each other there, heck of a lot of cavalry and infantry there. Masses of it. And as I say, it looks like our team has managed to go on to win. Hoss Luke has just admitted defeat there. And as I say, it's always a good thing to do when your team's lost and you can see the battle's over. Always best just to admit defeat, and then we get into the lobby, host up a new game, and then probably you'll get into a team that you'll win with. So, as I say, it's always always good to admit defeat when there's no chance of winning. And as I say, we get a new game going then. So, okay, the first thing I'd like to say is a really well played to everybody in the game. I thought everybody played well there. And as I say, I thought it would be a close victory, and as you can see, it is a close victory. Highest kills in the game goes to Brotherhood member Earth. Now remember, he had 8 infantry, archers, and fully upgraded cavalry, and he still got the highest kills in the game. So there you go, only 8 infantry, still highest kills in the game. So really well done, good tactical and strategic move in with that army of Roman army of choice of his. So well done to Hoss Luke, got some good kills there with his Brutii army. Well done to Mantu, bringing Dacia. Probably didn't get the kills that he wanted to there, but it was nice to see a different faction brought to 31k battlefield. Well done to LacJac, got some good kills there as well. And just to say well done to Surena, highest kills in his team. So really well done to Surena there, highest kills in his team. Really well played, guys. Some good moves there. That old army of mine there, I think I got the smallest army in the game and managed to get the second, scraping the second highest kills there. So I'm pleased with that very small army there. So I'd say pleased with that. And if you notice there, can you see the first and second highest kills there? Got small, quite smallish infantry there. Right, good kills for First Prime. Very aggressive, very attacking from the first there. Did well. And well done to Aurelius there. Held extremely well on that right flank. Got some good kills too. So really well played to everybody in the game there. I thought that was an exciting battle. And as I say, it was a close victory there. And I'd just like to say, really well done to the other team. Bearing in mind they had what some people would call a lesser 31k faction in Dacia, to make this a close victory, I think the other team played extremely well there against 3 Roman armies and Greek cities. Okay, Spartan Commander saying, hope you enjoyed the battle. See you soon.